Get ready for Truth Revolution Radio. The revolution starts now.
Earlier today, decided to check out a few clips on YouTube, going through just to see what's on there, and I found a couple of clips that'd be great for beginners to check out, just to show you how long this kind of stuff's been going on. Now, this first one, it seems like it's from the 80s. It's got Lindsay Wagner. For those of you who know her, she played the Bionic Woman. There was Lee Majors played the $6 Million Man, and the Bionic Woman was an offshoot of that. It's also got the guy who was in Honey, I Shrunk the Kids. He was the older brother. The next door neighbor had a crush on the daughter. So here's that for a start.
Let's start from the beginning. World history since 1776. Touch that and prepare to meet your doom. All right, question number one. Who was Adam Weishaupt?
He was a German Jewish professor who came up with the idea of one world government.
Okay, home team up one. The Illuminati, who are they?
They were the group founded by Weishaupt, and their aim was to create one world government.
To zip? I have never heard of this before.
It's because you went to school in the Dark Ages, Mom.
Hey. One more crack like that, kiddo, and it's the penalty box for you. What are all these references to Jews?
The Jews make up the Illuminati. They signed a pact with Lucifer saying that they would help take over the world and create one world government.
Oh, wait a minute.
So how does that grab you? The look on her face at the end there kind of says it all, doesn't it? And there's all kinds of clips out there like this. I'll end up probably editing in at least two or three per show. But to break up the monotony, today I've been listening to a lot of Billy Squire, and since this is going to be a radio station, the station's probably going to be a video radio station. Internet video radio. Yeah. Truth Revolution Radio, where we play videos as well as the song. So to get it started, here is a little Billy Squire.
Get ready for Truth Revolution Radio. The revolution starts now.
Now everybody, have you heard? If you're in the game, then the stroke's the word.
Oh,
Truth Revolution Radio.
All right, that was The Stroke from Billy Squire. I can promise you the video quality will get better by the time that station actually launches. It'll be on a totally different site. That was just a YouTube video for now. The last show I did the other day, I touched on Flat Earth. So I found a clip a lot of people may have seen or may have scrolled right by it on Facebook or YouTube. It should make the flat earthers at least a little bit giddy. It doesn't come right out and mention flat earth, but what it does do is prove that the cartographers fudged up big time when it came to the size and placement of countries and continents. So here's a little clip of that. It is from the show The West Wing. Okay, so check this one out.
Should we begin?
Yes. Plain and simple, we'd like President Bartlett to aggressively support legislation that would make it mandatory for every public school in America to teach geography using the Peters projection map instead of the traditional Mercator.
Give me $200 and it's done.
Really?
No. Why are we changing maps?
Because, CJ, the Mercator projection has fostered European imperialist attitudes for centuries and created an ethnic bias against the Third World.
Really?
The German cartographer, Mercator, originally designed this map in 1569 as a navigational tool for European sailors.
The map enlarges areas at the poles to create straight lines of constant bearing or geographic direction.
So it makes it easier to cross an ocean.
But
yes.
It distorts the relative size of nations and continents.
Are you saying the map is wrong?
Oh dear, yes. Look at Greenland.
Okay.
Now look at Africa.
Okay.
The two land masses appear to be roughly the same size.
Yes.
Would it blow your mind if I told you that Africa is in reality 14 times larger?
Yes.
Here we have Europe, drawn considerably larger than South America. When it's 6.9 million square miles, South America is almost double the size of Europe's 3.8 million.
Alaska appears three times as large as Mexico, when Mexico is larger by 0.1 million square miles.
Germany appears in the middle of the map when it's in the northernmost quarter of the Earth.
Wait. Relative size is one thing, but you're telling me that Germany isn't where we think it is?
Nothing's where you think it is.
Where is it?
I'm glad you asked.
So there you go, people. That's not made up. That's not just a TV show. That is a fact that they backdoored in through a TV show. You won't find any magazines doing stories about that. I mean, you might, but they'd be old magazines that you would find in, geez, like a library, if you're lucky. And there's a bunch of things like that going on. Even the treaty they've got going down in Antarctica, it's unheard of that they would maintain this treaty from, I believe it was 48, even up till now. No matter how pissed off they are at each other, whether it's Russia and Japan and China and America and Britain, when it comes to that treaty, they won't fucking break it. Well, since I'm still on a bit of a Billy Squire kick, I got another Billy Squire song. This one, I'm hoping the sound will be a little bit better at least. So here is Billy Squire, Rock Me Tonight, Truth Revolution Radio.
I want you tonight, I want you with me.
Truth Revolution Radio.
I've touched on medical marijuana before, and for good reason. So to end this show off of In the Dark with Steve Crawford, here's a little clip of Samuel L. Jackson, and I'm going to finish it off with one more Billy Squier tune. Stick around to figure out which one that is. Have a good night, everybody.
The Avengers weed?
It's good. We do have.
The Hulk? The green?
And we also have this.
One big green bud. Muscle.
You would think he'd relax more if he was doing that much weed, but no.
No, not him. It's just, that's what the weed's called. Hulk.
So Nick Fury's like, he's the ringleader in this movie. In real life, how would Sam Jackson keep all of those guys in check?
The Hulk. Give him that green weed that you got in that bag right there.
You're going to get me in trouble. They think I'm bringing weed to the interview.
Give him that
now.
Marvel weed that's in the bag right there. The Hulk. The Hulk. Buy it. Get your prescription tomorrow for the Hulk.
Would you say it is more fun?
Not the dark green.
Mm-mm.
The iridescent green.
It just keeps you cooler.
Rage machine, baby.
I think I'm going to get fired through this, but I kind of like this, going down in flames. Who wins in a fight? All these Avengers get together. Who comes out on top? You're sort of the unbiased character in this. You can sort of take a step back.
Comes out on top? I mean, pretty much the Hulk.
Right.
Mean, why? Because he's indefatigable.
Oh, nice.
He's indestructible.
Yes.
And he is that iridescent green weed. It was the experiment. Everybody wants to say it was some big thing blowing up. No. He picked up this hybrid bud that got caught inside the atomic room that day. And for some reason, he ate it, didn't smoke it, ate it.
Oh, see?
Like a brownie. I'm just going to say it straight out. You know, you should see the Avengers after you hit like one great big bud of Hulk. Because this movie is a yes!